Just another late night with my bitch. Just another late night.
Drake equals don't miss. This is an album you send to your ex to stun on her. Could I have treated you better?
No! Not at all.
For Drake, it's like anybody gets personal with him, he's like, I'm just gonna shut up. You know what I mean? Like, I'm just gonna make a song about them. When you get to a point in life where you're like that, and it's gotta be super tough for people to even want to have a personal relationship with you, because it's like, is he gonna shit on me next? And yeah, like the next song that billions of people are gonna listen to. I know you had talked about how he's probably gonna take a hiatus at this point. Who do you think on a male level is gonna be able to even take a crack to fill that spot?
Yo, all of the dogs.
Bark.
For all the f***ing dogs, Drizzy Drake has delivered. So, just to add a little insight, today is the day that Drake dropped For All of the Dogs, the day we're recording. Today. This morning. Pretty much, we listened to the full album. And I have to say, Drake equals don't miss. And that's just my first takeaway from the album. What did you think of?
I definitely think that like Drake brought it back to old Drake, in the sense of he was throwing in and incorporating the rap, but it was mostly like a hip-hop R&B album.
Absolutely.
There wasn't a lot of rap going on. There was definitely rap in the songs, but it was more focused on the R&B aspect. I also liked how he didn't put all the features in the titles of the songs. Right. I think he made it unique by not, you know, saying like, you know, obviously there was whispers about who was going to be in the new album and things like that. Jack Harlow was not. But with that being said, you know, it was very cool that he did that, just because he made it different. I know you had talked about how he's probably going to take a hiatus at this point.
Yeah, he said he was taking a hiatus for at least a year.
Yeah.
I know he said it's like some health problems he wants to take care of. I think he said he has some sick stomach stuff and he wants to get healthy, be a little bit more healthy. Probably take time with his son and things.
Somebody
of that nature.
That's gonna be, you know, making money even when Drake's not making the money, just because
exactly.
He got signed on that album.
Yeah, he was on the album.
He did a great job.
We had Drake and J. Cole, which was really cool. That was something that like I didn't think we would get ever again, and that was a dope little collab.
Especially too, because like I hate J. Cole. I don't like any of his music. I think that some of his music is good.
Mm-hmm.
Not the ones that are blasted all over mainstream, but like some of his like Under the Sun, where he does like features with other artists and stuff like that. That stuff's good. You know, he can definitely play his basses there. But yeah, it was definitely cool to see him with Drake, because, you know, it's probably never going to happen again.
Exactly. But what I like listening to the album and the vibe of the album, I said this, I'm like, this is an album you send to your ex to stun on her. And it's kind of like the things he was saying, it was kind of like, yeah, like, could I have treated you better?
Probably. No, no, not at all.
Right.
No, I couldn't have treated you better. I gave you everything. No.
Right.
And it was like, God damn, this kid's. There was so many
That's
times.
That's been very personal.
Oh, it was very. Somebody he was. There was like the way he put this together. He was talking about at least one or two women specifically.
Six individual people.
Yeah, specifically. Like, he was like, this is for, like, I hope you're listening. The whole world is going to hear. He even said it, like, he was in one of the songs. He's like, this could have been a lot worse.
It's got to be super difficult to even be involved with a pop star like Drake.
Mm-hmm.
Just in the sense that you would feel that anything that you do wrong in that moment, like a comedian, like from my aspect, like if somebody does something like kind of effed up or kind of funny in the friend group or in like a personal life, like I'm going to write some shit down. I'm going to make a joke out of it. I'm going to choreograph it. I'm going to put it on paper. I'm going to keep it. Might not be funny later, but it's funny right now.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? For Drake, it's like anybody gets personal with him, he's like, I'm just going to shit on him. You know what I mean? Like, I'm just going to make a song about them and shit on them. And it's going to be the best song in the world. Because why? I'm Drake. You know what I mean? And it's like, when you get to a point in life where you're like that, it's got to be super fucking tough for people to even want to have a personal relationship with you. Because it's like, is he going to shit on me next? At, like, the next song that billions of people are going to listen to?
I think definitely.
He says any little interview that he goes on gets taken down or is not even relevant or not even up. You know what I mean? So it's just like, yeah, man, for people like micromanaging Drake and watching every little move he does to like be a personal member in his life and not get put on a song, like, you know.
And that's what I was saying. Like, you heard this, like, the savagery. It's some of those things that, like, when you're talking to a woman that you like, you want to say to her,
right,
but
you
like
don't.
Her,
right.
So you don't. And Drake was like, no. I'm going to say it.
Yeah. Let me wipe the mirrors off real quick before I tell
you.
I
sent
you
more money than your father did.
Right.
I spent more money on your kid than your baby daddy did.
That I could have spent on the boys.
Like, I could have spent that money on the boys.
The boys.
Like, and I was sitting there. I'm like, he is right.
Yeah.
Like, it was great. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed it. I think that if he does take this little hiatus, right? And he said at least a year.
Mm-hmm.
So we can say, he said he's not going to be in the studio for at least a year. Not he's not going to drop anything. So
yeah.
If he's not in the studio for a year, I'm sure with a big artist, it takes about a year to put together an album or so. That means for the next 2 to 3 years, more likely, we wouldn't have any Drake music like that. So does that leave hip hop kind of in a weird place? Because there's nobody that we can look to say, hey, you can take this mantle. You're the next guy.
I don't know how other artists feel about it. Personally, being in the field, how I take it as is that Drake is obviously one of the best. You know what I mean? I can't say he is the best, but qualifying, he's one of the best. You know what I mean? He gets that title. And to be able to take a break like that, like for example in my life, like Dave Chappelle for comedy, and then come back and then still have the same career or a bigger career is definitely taking a risk. And with other members in that field wanting to take a crack at that position, there's definitely going to be a lot more fight for, like, it's going to be like a bunch of hyenas cleaning up some scraps, bro. Like, somebody's going to want to take that overall challenge to be where Drake is, I guess you could say. So I'm definitely expecting to see, like, more people releasing more things and more of their heat and more projects in that time frame that if Drake does take a break, just because, I mean, that's their time to shine. It's like a new generation rolling over in. Now, with that being said, when I think Drake comes back, he's going to be at the same place that he was, or he's going to be bigger because people are going to be wanting or needing his music. Because just because other people are going to be trying to win their way to the top doesn't mean they're going to be able to pull off having albums like Drake does. And Drake's been doing shit back to back to back to back to back to back for a while now. So it's like, to even sit here and say that the artist should still keep performing and he still should be like performing music and writing music is super selfish on our part, because he's given us so much in the time that he has.
Absolutely. So, and I mean, think about this. Drake really burst onto the scene in like 2009.
Right.
It is 2023.
Going into 24.
Going into 24.
And he's already shifted his whole career again at the end of 2023. Not even like a Tom Brady moment. Like, you could still make millions of dollars sitting here and doing this, or you could, you know what I mean? You know, go try to play football again and be terrible.
Yeah, exactly. So that's the thing. Like, I mean, I'm looking at it and it's like, I just don't see the artist that's going to come and like fill that void. Now maybe somebody surprises you, but
who do you think that would have the best chance? That, because right now female rap is like becoming the most prolific. I mean, for female rap and like more of like that UK grime kind of style, you know what I mean? So I mean, who do you think would be, without it being a female artist, because we already know that, you know what I mean, Sexy Red is going up, Ice Spice is still going up, you know, I'm Suki Hana, I guess, is up there
Meg.
As well.
Glow.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, Nicki. who do you think on a male level? Well, I mean, Nicki's OG, Cardi. Of course. But I mean, when it comes down to it, it's like, who do you think on a male level is going to be able to even take a crack to fill that spot?
If you would have asked me this a couple years ago, I would have said Little Baby.